Hello everyone and welcome to Honda's 2022 Civic Touring. This is the beginning of an all new generation, the 11th generation for Honda's incredibly popular mass market sedan. And there have been some rather thorough revisions for this new product. It's slightly longer, slightly wider, a little heavier, but critically to most people, more fuel efficient, and to some, a much cleaner interior and exterior design. Of the 6 years that the 10th generation Civic was on sale, I truly was never a fan of the looks. Outside of the Civic Type R, I didn't feel like the wildly edgy design of the Civic really suited the overall character. And at the end of the day, it was a good product, but it never really suited my taste. But the design of this, to me personally, I think is fantastic. And there's obviously a fair amount to discuss that is new for this product. You've got new everything, essentially, even a new key and new indicator slash wiper stalks, stuff that I'm sure will show up in other Hondas in the future. And introducing all of these little elements into what is one of their best-selling products, I really like that bold approach to this 11th generation vehicle. But let's talk about the mechanical changes that have come along for the sedan. Primarily, we have lost the manual transmission in the sedan. With the upcoming hatchback, that will be available with the manual transmission, but the two engine options here in the Civic sedan are only going to be paired with Honda's CVT. You have two engine choices, the familiar 2-liter naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine and the 1.5-liter turbocharged four-cylinder engine. There's a slight increase in power, and I'm in the top trim Touring, which in Canada is the only way you can get the 1.5-liter engine for the Civic sedan. It has 180 horsepower and 177 pound-feet of torque. To quickly go over what I think of the driving experience of this Civic, really, I do like it. There's a lot of nice elements here all putting together for a very pleasant overall experience. First of all of the inputs require a little bit of heft, so there's a little bit of effort from the steering, a little bit of effort in the brake and the throttle, so it feels quite involving. And with this CVT, it has been tuned to have fake gear shifts when you reach the red line, and this is the best version of a CVT that I think you can find really anywhere on any product in the car market. It will act more like a traditional automatic transmission when you are reaching that red line where the fake shifts are happening. But when you're, let's say, leaving a stoplight or just any gradual pace of speed, the revs do naturally climb, and it doesn't ever feel like you shift, because if you're just doing very calm acceleration, you're never really getting over 2,000 or 3,000 RPM. And the turbo response is pretty good. When you launch from lower speeds, there really is quite a lot of pickup, and I wouldn't say that the turbo lag is at all noticeable. It does come along very steadily. And 180 horsepower is enough puff to easily get you up to speed when merging onto a highway or in the need of quickly overtaking someone. No problem at all. In terms of ride, the Civic, I would say, has a little bit of a firmer ride, maybe because we're on these 18-inch rims that are set up for the Touring, that it feels perhaps a little more involved than some might expect. But the Civic still has an independent rear suspension system where a couple of its rivals, such as the Mazda 3 in its latest format and the latest generation of the VW Jetta, went with a solid beam rear axle. This certainly has a little more sophistication. So I think the suspension tuning nicely matches the rest of the driver inputs and the feedback that you get when operating the Civic. Couple other things I'll mention about driving. There's really good visibility. I feel like there's lots of glass. I've got this seat as low as it can go, so plenty of headroom for someone 6'4" like me. On the note of getting the seat really low as well, I can pitch the front of the seat base up, so I have quite a good amount of underleg support, and there's a lot of open space behind the pedals, which as a tall person you will appreciate, so you can stretch your legs out further beyond the brake pedal and even give your rear passengers some extra space if they need it. And the touring model actually gets a little bit more of sound deadening material in the wheel wells and on the base of the floor compared to the other new Civic. So the road noise is well kept and what you should expect out of a modern compact sedan in this mainstream line of vehicles. How much quieter is it? I honestly won't be able to say. I haven't tested out a non-touring version of the Civic. Hopefully in the very near future I will be able to and report on that difference in the comments section down below. But for now, I'd say in this touring specification, the road noise and the wind noise is what you should expect out of this class. For me, I only have one real issue with the driving, and that's when you look in the rearview mirror. The rearview glass, I do think, is a bit slim, but that truly is the largest criticism that I have towards the driving experience of this Civic. Now, I wanted to be quick about the driving feel because that might not really matter to most people buying this Civic or shopping in this class of vehicle, but it does matter, and I'm sure people that get behind the wheel will appreciate it. But what they will certainly appreciate is the cleanliness and just the attention to detail of the cabin of the Civic. So all of the buttons that I am interacting with feel as rich and have such a lovely sound to them, in the same way that you would hope to get that positive response from touching a button or turning a wheel or using just this little knob here for the flow of air. It all feels like it should be coming out of a BMW or an Audi. It really is that solid. And the rest of the cabin space, I think, is fairly well put together. There's a little bit of flex here in the door cards, but hardly the end of the world. And this big strip of honeycomb mesh gives you something to look at and admire. Something that I won't label in the same sense of admiration is the amount of piano black plastic that is in this Civic. I think it's a little bit of a shame. It's on the door cards, on the steering wheel, and all the way across the dash, filling the space above and below that honeycomb mesh. It's just always going to be dirty, always going to be greasy. It's probably going to be scratched up over time. You have this little texturized component down here with your shifter and your big cup holders, which I would have liked to see in these areas where the piano black plastic is, or maybe wrap it to be a satin finish. I think that could look quite good. But if this was my own personal vehicle, I would go out of my way, spend the additional money to do that. So the design, all well and good. Very minimal buttons, easy controls, nothing that you have to learn or really worry about. There's a little bit of customization here in the digital screen, 10.2 inches, just what you'd see in the larger Accord sedan, with a little bit of customization, but not much more to it. There's a few other pieces of thoughtful details, like I was saying here, with interacting with the physical controls, interacting with this screen here. So for example, if I set the cruise control, which here in the Civic does also have the radar assist system, but you can isolate it. You can have normal cruise control or radar assisted cruise control. I really appreciate that. When you select the lane keep assist system and the green lines are highlighted, they'll actually see far enough ahead of you and read the curve or the turns in the road. And with the touring, you're getting more equipment than you've ever seen before in a Civic. So we've got a Bose sound system for the first time, the full digital instrument cluster, like I said. The Civic really is a car for everyone, and there's nothing in here that I think would really divide opinion. Everything is so well executed. The driving experience is more than pleasant enough. And to me, I really quite like the looks of this 11th generation. I think this is so successful of a product that it might give the Accord a little bit of trouble in the future. Yes, the Accord has a little more space inside and maybe has a little more road presence, but the way that sedan sales are going in North America, and even how good of a product the Accord is, it just isn't selling in the same way that the Pilots or the Passports are. if Honda had to drop the Accord and make the Civic its one and only sedan, I would honestly think it would be a competent enough product as long as you don't need more space in the rear or in the trunk. And to talk about those things, again, I'm 6'4", and sitting behind myself here in the Civic is a little bit tight. I'm definitely pressing my head up against the roof liner and my knees are jamming into the back of the seat. The trunk space is nice and wide and the floor goes low. You still have a space saver spare wheel underneath the false floor too. So there you go. Those are my thoughts on the new Civic sedan. This is a car that if you aren't considering, then maybe someone in your family is, maybe someone at your job, someone on your street. This is obviously going to be a very successful product for Honda, not only because it's affordable and has many of the features that consumers are looking for, as it has been in many years previous, the Civic is just a very good product. I am desperately excited to find out what the SI version turns out to be or the Type R version of this product. It's just everything that a product in this category should be and does it so, so well. So thank you very much for watching and I hope to see you again on the channel soon.